floor. Will you? I just want to show. This was Big Boys. It doesn't even show
how. Look at this.
This is how big he was. Now, take a look at how little he is. Florin, go have a look. He's right there. This is unbelievable.
Crazy.
And he's written a book to talk about his weight loss. There he is. Come on up.
Big boy.
Wow.
Hello.
You look amazing.
You look amazing.
Are you getting?
I know.
You're even smaller than the last time we saw you.
No. I'm doing that new year, new you stuff right now.
I'm about to grab it. That's a good idea. Can I just say hello to your better half before we get started?
As you should.
Your beautiful wife.
She's the one, you know, I was running late, so she was like, well, get in the carpool lane, take the fine, get over there.
Take the fine is right. That's what I do when I'm late. You got it.
Is that 405?
Do you look at that and think, that's a whole other person.
Yeah, and you know what? That was like my my light jacket, the so-called smaller jacket right there.
You gotta be kidding.
How
much did you weigh?
I weighed, my scale weight was 510 pounds. That's what I seen on the scale.
That's insane.
No, you had to have different scales also.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I had a scale that was 600.
Around you.
And this all started with
the belt. Tell me about it. Yeah.
Let's talk about that.
It started with Will Smith. Will Smith, we had Will on air, and Will did a challenge where he paid me $1,000 per pound for charity. So I ended up losing 111 pounds for charity. Mm. But once I finished that, my first thing was like, okay, I'm going to do this final weigh-in because we're like 6 months. But after we do this final weigh-in, I'm going to go get some chicken nachos from this restaurant that I love. So I go get the chicken nachos, and that weight just started coming back on. And that was the first time I felt like lower back pain. And
interesting.
Yeah, you know, pains in my leg, like everything that everybody else that was obese or big would complain about, I never had
those
problems.
You never had that?
No, but it was coming on.
It was also part of your radio personality, the persona, the billboards that were out there. It was sort of what, you know, we identified with you.
Right.
Was anybody concerned that you were losing weight?
I get people all the time. I still get people like, oh, man, stop. You know what I'm saying?
Wow.
But it was more so, it was a decision I had to make because I really felt that if I didn't get everything, kind of my hands around everything, that I was going to be dead in a year.
But it was your identity. And
yeah.
is that hard now going from your identity to a different identity? Has it been a gradual?
Still, right now, even as I'm in the green room, I'm looking at myself. Like, because you got to think, I have been fat, chubby, severe morbid obese my whole life.
Well, how old are you in this?
I'm 13
picture?
There.
Okay,
I'm
so did you go through, was it sort
Hi,
of, aw, there's no. a mamala. Was it one of those things that you just sort of got used to, whether it was, did people pick on you at all?
No, you know what?
You
I wasn't that guy.
That's
I wasn't
the
one that,
for, and,
yeah, and that was always even before radio, so I wasn't the guy that you could pull up his shirt or you could punk me or such. You know, I was a guy, I had girls,
you
I had people
cool
that
guy.
Were around me. Yeah.
So is it hard now?
It's not hard, it's different, because you had lived a life and you were so used to a certain way.
Well, you could almost hide behind your fat in a way, and now you're still the same person inside, but the exterior.
Well, you said that you just even now looked in the mirror in the green room.
Constantly.
What do you think?
It's like sometimes, even I'm walking down a hallway, I can't believe it. Because you got to think, this is still very new to me.
And your wife has been with you through thick and thin.
Yeah, exactly, literally. Yeah,
and
that's my best friend, that's my teammate.
She's like, oh, please gain it all back. Oh, come
you know,
on.
She's one that would tell me, like, honey, you know, like, oh, you're so skinny. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So.
And wait, for you to hear those words, very foreign. And what was that like?
You know, hearing skinny or small, I never heard that in my life. And it was crazy because about 2 months ago, I was at my son's school. And kids have no mental editor. Kids are the worst that you can get.
Well, we don't either here.
I've noticed. You know what I'm saying? But it's crazy because I got in the car and my son, I went to go pick him up from school. He wasn't finished eating his lunch. So it was about 30 kids around. And I'm waiting for him to finish, letting him have his fun, so on and so forth. But as I get in the car, it dawned on me that none of the kids said, hey, Jaden, your dad is fat. Or, you know, because kids don't have that mental
editor. They don't have the filter.
So that also was like, damn, big, like, you really lost a lot of weight. Because you would get kids that would say, hey, mom, look at the fat guy. Or, you know what I'm saying? So to be around 40 kids and not hear that. It's crazy.
So
I'm looking at the monitor still like, dang.
Is that me?
Yeah.
Who's that guy? Is that Denzel over there?
Stop that. Denzel even at the crib like, stop it, Jim.
What's the book about?
The book
Wait,
is
can
really,
I just ask
go
before
ahead,
that?
Please.
How did you lose it? How are you continuing to lose it?
I
know some of that is in the book.
I got a procedure called the duodenal switch. And duodenal switch, I got that 8 years ago. That's the most extreme gastric bypass you can have.
Is.
Like, there's lap bands and room wise and things of that nature. But I felt like I needed something that was real drastic because I had to do something
what
to really save my life. That right there is, it's a surgery that it malabsorbs everything. The way you lose the weight is you malabsorb the fats. But with malabsorbing the fats, you malabsorb everything, protein, calcium. So I'm constantly on supplements. I'm driving here eating protein bars, drinking protein shakes.
So that's
because
the best.
I got very sick after my procedure.
I know you did, and you talked about that. You were very open about that. And did you find anything therapeutic about writing the book?
The whole book.
Yeah.
Because you realize, like, there were layers that I had to take off doing the book. And you're big boy, you're happy, and you know, you're this guy. But then once you start speaking about your life and thinking about, okay, did I have a love affair with food? You don't get to 500 pounds eating.
And not have loving it.
You know what I'm saying? So food was always there. When we were, it's seven kids. And
you fight for your food.
Yeah, and you always, you know, that was the one thing we had, being homeless. We always,
your
always
inspiration. Compatible to food. I always say, and this especially about you, is that you relate yourself to, and that's why people love you, your listeners love you. And if you love him, go buy his book, Big Boy's book, and Extra Large Life is on sale now. And you can also check out Big Boy at RadioBigBoy.com. Much love to you.
Are you going
to
change your handle at all?
Not at all.
No,
I'm still big
that's
in heart.
Who you are.
No,
I like that.
Coming up, making his live debut on American television, James McCartney is going to perform for us. He is
unbelievable. So good.
Look at this jacket. It's really
I got this.
There's something light about that jacket.
This is